Good morning, Barry Bryson here. We're in the Gospel of Mark. We're going to be reading verses 1 through 8 today of chapter 16. It's Sunday morning. Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James and Salome, are going to arrive at the tomb in order to do right by the body of Jesus. It's always touched me, and all four Gospels are clear that the women are the ones who are there. The women and the prominent male disciples who are not really in close orbit until after the death of Jesus. Those closest to Jesus, they just disappear. They're not there. So it's Sunday morning, and they're wondering who's going to roll the stone away, but they get there and the stone is already rolled away. And this is what happened. Mark chapter 16, verses 1 through 8. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Salome, bought spices that they might come and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb when the sun had risen. And they were saying to one another, "Who will roll the stone away, the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb?" And looking up, they saw that the stone had been rolled away, even though it was extremely large. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting at the right, wearing a white robe, and they were amazed. And he said to them, "Do not be amazed. You are looking for Jesus the Nazarene, who has been crucified. He has risen. He is not here. Behold, here is the place where they laid him. But go and tell his disciples and Peter, he is going before you into Galilee. There you will see him, just as he said to you." And they went out and fled from the tomb, for trembling and astonishment had gripped them, and they said nothing to anyone because they were afraid. Now, the 16th chapter of Mark is a bit problematic. We'll talk about that next time. But today, we want to just focus on verses 1 through 8 and what's actually written in these 8 verses. There are some ways that it doesn't exactly coincide with the details of some of the other Gospels. But that's okay. Mark's gospel and the other gospels, the women immediately go and tell the men, and the men don't really believe them. John's gospel, Peter and John come to the tomb to see for themselves. And Mark's gospel says their first response was to run away and to shake and be afraid. And that can all be true together. I mean, seriously, doesn't that make sense that that would happen? And they would find someone and tell them about it. So they come first thing Sunday morning. The sun had risen. They're worried about the stone. It's already rolled away. And they see this person in white who is an angelic presence. And he says, you know, "You're looking for Jesus. I know why you're here. You're looking for Jesus the Nazarene. But he is risen." Jesus told them over and over again just days before that he was going to rise on the third day. And he did arise on the third day, but for some reason, none of them, not even the women disciples, are expecting this to happen. And he says he's going to go before you into Galilee. That happens. They meet Jesus on the Sea of Galilee. They see him in Jerusalem and in Galilee. And then they go tell his disciples and Peter. That's just a curious phrase, as if Peter were not one of the disciples. And maybe in Peter's own mind, he didn't feel like he was anymore because of his actions. Not that Peter doubted, but it's such an interesting detail, and especially since Peter is likely the source of this gospel, which we'll talk about more in detail tomorrow. We talked about when we introduced it, that it's phrased that way. It's almost a signature of Peter's that it's phrased that way. "Go tell his disciples and Peter, he is going before you into Galilee." And then it says they were afraid, fear gripped them. They didn't say anything to anybody at first. They were just shaking because they were so afraid. And many will argue this is where the Gospel of Mark ought to end. Those people would be wrong, but the ending of Mark is puzzling. and we'll talk about that next time. I have taken now barely 5 minutes of your time for once in many, many moons. I've kept my promise. Thank you so much for joining me for another 5 good minutes. We're going to talk about the multiple endings, possible endings of the Book of Mark next time. Thank you for joining me.